fantastic support. These are Swedish traditional pins, charity pins that you can buy in April and May each year, every year. So it's a small flower that you can have on your coat, on your collar. And it's been a Swedish tradition since 1907. So it's more than 110 years old. Flowers when I was a kid. That's why I have this homemade folder here. With some brochures that I got, some folders. Schooled, actually, you got a lot of information from about Mayblomman, as these are called, Mayflower, because it's kids who are selling these through the school, so. And the profit also goes to kids in need. So it's children helping children. That's the idea of it. But I must say, I didn't care much about the charity aspect of it as a kid. I just liked to collect. And to look at these kinds of cards where you could see how the flowers look like for each year. And I never had a complete collection. But I think actually I had the third one. That was my oldest in my collection from 1909. You can see every flower from 1907 to 2007. It's 101 different. combinations, different styles. Here you can see all the flowers from 1907 to 1957. Some years there are two variations, even though I actually can't see any difference on these two from 1964 or from 1965 or from 1973. They look identical to me. 1966 I could see a slightly different shade of green in the center, perhaps. But there are years where you can see more significant differences, variations. Here you can see the center, color of the center, the flower. This one, 1942, you can see that one variation still has this center, three-dimensional center of glass, and the other variation, there are flat center made of paper, and the following years they continued with the flat center. Here you can see all the flowers from 1907 to 1991. From 1907 to 1988. From 1907 to 1987. Some information about the summer camp where children in need, or from maybe ill children, or children from low income families, they got the chance to spend some time in the summer by selling these flowers, these pins, 1907 to 1982, with 1983 and 1984 added, drawn by hand. I think there was also a fantasy added from is from 1618, actually. This one, it looks like real flowers binded together. Some kind of stem. Doesn't look like a needle. On 1907 you can also see some text added. It's the year when Hershey was born. See all the flowers from 1907 to 1981. Here's Peter Hallberg, born in 1869 and dead. From 1907 to 1977. And here they are from 1907 to 1973. Some information. Here's the most recent one. It's all the flowers from 1907 to 2015. Actually bought this book last week. When I started to think about doing this video, here's Peter Hallberg again. Here you can see all the flowers from 1907 to 1969. This book is from 1970. You can see this is the flower from 1970. If you compare, find it here. It's a red petals and a green center. That's a lot of information about the history. Here's the prototype. Peter Hallberg found somewhere. Then she got the idea to make a flower, a pin, look like this. the first, I think you can call it Mayflower in English, the first Mayflower from 1907. Here's Peter Halberg. Selling Mayflowers on the streets. I think this must be 1919, because you can see this is how the flower looked in 1919. It's the blue anemone year. Here's how the flower looked in 1913. But I guess that's just decoration. I don't know why you should just show the flowers from 1913 and 1919. Otherwise, this is from a magazine cover. The idea was also exported to other countries. Here you can see they are selling similar flowers in Denmark and Norway. Here, ladies from all those three Nordic countries are on the same photo with the flags. Norway, Sweden, no Danish flag. So I guess this is Peter Halberg in the middle. Also says some interesting about the US. The idea was exported to the US as well. From the beginning it was a hospital for the Swedish Americans who had the immigrants. And costed 10 cents, it says here. Produced in the Providence, except for 1927 and 1931 when they were imported from Gothenburg. And a new hospital was built in 1931. Mostly for people suffering in tuberculosis. And then when Tuberculosis no longer was a huge problem. A couple of years later, it was changed the name to Swedish Medical Center in 1959. Here you can read about each year. The colors and the material of each flower from 1907 to 1971, actually. So I guess this book must be from 1971. Just 1970. Maybe they had already decided how 1971 would look like. It says dark cobalt blue, made of celluloid, 3 layers. Center made of glass in amber color. So that's the first one. It's really rare. I think there were written some. I think this could be like how much it was sold for, 2,500 crowns at some point. That's $150, but you can see compared to 1911, sold for 125 crowns, only $12.50. So this first one is much rarer than the rest. I guess there weren't so many produced, but since it was such a success, already in 1908, there were a lot of more of these produced. Also, I think this was only in Gothenburg, and from 1908 they were sold all over Sweden, and also other countries. Soon. Now I have told you a little about this, and actually what I would like to show you now is how I use this information today, because I still keep thinking of these flowers every now and then, and I noticed that it has become a way for me to memorize things, to memorize numbers, because when I was a kid I learned. I studied these, all these different colors and shapes and materials so accurate. Spent so many hours on this. And when you're a kid, you like learn for the rest of your life. So I have noticed that I can quite immediately combine a two-digit number to one of these flowers. So if you skip 19, because they all almost all of them starts with 19. 19. So here you have 24, 25, 26. So when I hear a number with two digits, then I don't have to think. I just see this flower, I feel it. And I mean, 24 and 35 looks quite similar, perhaps, at first glance, but actually there is a difference. Here you can see a green color underneath these petals. It's actually green sepals. Turn it around, you can see the that green sepals, and 35, there are no green sepals on the back. Also 1944, or let's call it just 44, looks quite similar to 50, perhaps, but there's a slightly difference even there. 44 is made of green paper, so even where the paper is cut, the edges, thin edges, it's a green color. In 1950, it's on white paper. The color is somehow printed, so you can see the white edges here. So that's how you can tell the difference from one year to another, if you studied them carefully. But for example, if I have to memorize a code, PIN code, four digits, then I just have to think about combination of two of these flowers. Actually, I have some problems with the later years here. It's a bit sad that it starts with 7, because how to memorize the numbers 1 up to 6, that has always been a problem. And then you have to flowers from after the millennium, 2000, 2001, 2003, 2004, 2005, and 2006. And I must say, I try to learn these now, but since I didn't learn these when I was a kid, I will always find these a bit more difficult to memorize. Someone says 04, I don't see this flower immediately before my eyes. I somehow can have forgotten it, or I have to think before I see it. I think I can see say 2000 quite immediately, but here it starts to get more difficult. So what number 1 2 3 4 5 6 digits for me to remember. Because now I started to think about maths, and I know that some of you don't find maths relaxing at all, but then you can just listen, and you don't have to feel that you need to memorize or understand this at all. About some constants in math, some small numbers, where it's important. It makes a big difference if the decimals aren't right. For example, pi, 2. I don't know exactly square root of 2, but square root of 2, 1.414213562. You could say this is almost like 1.5, but if you calculate using 1.5, when it's supposed to be square root of 2, then the calculations get really strange after a while, I think. So when it's small numbers, it's quite important that you use accurate decimals. So that's when I come up with the idea to memorize some of these numbers, constants that you stumble upon a lot if you're doing maths. And I would like to try to remember these and memorize these. And I will use this method, like I said. See if it can help me. But I will, since I can only remember two decimals, that's the limit for me, so I'm not going to try to learn pi in more than two decimals, or any other of the numbers. So, let's start with pi. Decimals, it's 3.14, and I won't forget that pi is 3 point something, so let's just remember it's 14, so this flower, I guess it could be like is a daisy, but then it's a yellow daisy shaped flower. In the beginning there were actually some flowers resembling real flowers. So this is it's a heartsease or wild pansy. This is a rose. This is the wood anemone, the blue anemone. And this strange flower here is violet. When I was a kid, I thought this was the most ugly. Daisy here, and this yellow flower that I refer to as a dandelion. But let's go on with some more numbers. Yeah, let's take pi again. Over 2. That's 1.57. Then I will remember 57 for pi over 2. 57 is the first flower made of plastic. These were made of paper. And then these were made of celluloid, the old type of plastic. These were celluloid as well. These were fabric. These were made of paper. The celluloid ones, I guess, are very flammable. I read somewhere that celluloid can like start to fire of itself somehow. I don't know how that works, but plastic era starts here from 57, and there are plastic until 97. Then they are made of paper again. Thick paper here, and then thinner paper. Let's memorize. So that's 28. This is one of the flowers I really liked it. It's very deep violet, purple, deep purple, you could say. It's a nice color. It's the only one with that color, I think, as well. That's 2 times pi. And if we take pi times 2/3, so 2 pi over 3. That's 2.09. So this one, all yellow flower. On the back, the back layer is more darker green than the front petal. Let's take similar to 47, but I think 47 is more grayish, and this is more ultramarine color. Can't really tell the difference on this picture, but that's how I remember it. And in the beginning they used to have blue flowers every 5 years, so every year ending with the 7, because it was celebrated the like 20-year celebration, 30-year celebration, 40-year celebration, 50 years, 60 years, and so on. And also every year ending with a 2, so this was 60, then this is 55 years celebration, and 45 year celebration, 35 years celebration, and there 100 celebration also. Blue flower. Okay, I think we're done with the pi digits, decimals. Let's continue with constant is 2.72. It's quite important to know. I guess it's as important as pi. So 72. 2.72, that's E. It's a blue plastic flower, but quite strange. I've always thought of this flower as a bit strange, not very beautiful. It has white back petals. Some natural logarithms. So if you take the natural logarithm of 2, that's 0.69. Natural logarithm of 3. It's 1.10. If we only count 2 digits, or I mean decimals, then it's 1.10. Yeah, that's good. It's another light blue one. The light blue flowers aren't that many, so then we have a connection between the logarithm of 2 and logarithm of 3. So it's 1.10. Some square roots now. Square root of 2. It's 1.4. one. The paper, pale green paper flower with a red glass center, and also the last year with a glass center. If we don't count the this optional 42 flower that also had a glass center. Anyway, 41, that's square root of 2. And square root of 2 over 2. 0.71 is this purple plastic flower. Let's go on with square root of 3. It's 1.73. And it's this one, 73. Yellow flower with the red center. The material, the plastic material, was a bit thicker 10 years later. These are quite thin, almost like a transparent feel of it, maybe more fragile. Then we have 0.87. You need to memorize 87. One of the blue flowers. Very similar to 82. Has two shades of blue, also 97. Here's the darker color on the back.